Hi, I'm Mike Marin, and in this video, we'll talk about modifying plots produced using R. The modifications we will discuss apply to most plots that we can produce, although we will focus on the scatter plot for the sake of simplicity and sticking to discussing one plot. We will be working with the lung capacity data that was introduced earlier in this series of videos. I've already gone ahead and imported the data into R and attached it. You can explore the help menu for the command PAR to see all the different plotting parameters that may be changed, or simply throw a question mark in front of the command PAR. We will discuss only a few of the changes from this menu. We will begin with a simple scatter plot comparing age to height . The first thing we can discuss is changing the size of the plotting characters used. We can do this using the cex argument. Setting this equal to 0.5 will result in plotting characters half of the original size. We may also change the size of the title using the cex.main argument. Setting this equal to 2 will result in a larger size title. We can change the size of the x and y labels using the cex.lab argument. Setting this equal to 1.5 will again result in larger x and y labels. Finally, we can change the size of the x and y axis values using the cex.axis argument. Setting this equal to 0.7 will result in x and y values that are 70% of their original size. Now let's go back to the simple scatter plot that we started with and discuss changing fonts. We can change the fonts used in a similar manner. Using the font.main argument can change the font used for the title. Setting this equal to 3 will use an italicized font. Setting it equal to 4 will use a bold italicized font. We may also want to change the font used for the X or Y labels. This can be done using the font.lab argument. Setting this equal to 2 will use a bold font. Finally, we may want to change the fonts used for the x and y axis. This can be done using the font.axis argument. Setting this equal to 3 will result in italicized fonts. Again, let's go back to the simple scatter plot that we started with, and now we can talk about changing colors on the plot. We can change the color of the plotting characters using the col argument. Here we'll set this to be color 5. In a similar manner as before, we can change the color of the title using the col.main argument. We'll set this to color 4. We can change the color of the x and y labels using the col.lab argument. We'll use color 2. And we can change the color of the x and y axis using the col.axis argument. We'll set this to color 3. It's worth noting here that you probably do not want to produce a plot with this many different colors on it. What we are doing here is simply for the sake of demonstration of how colors may be changed. Now, let's go back to that simple scatter plot that we started with again, and talk about how we can change plotting characters. We can change the plotting character that we're using by using the PCH argument. We may set this to a number to use one of the plotting characters stored within R. For example, plotting character number 2 is a triangle. Or we may use the PCH argument and in quotations throw a particular character that we would like to be used. For example, a W will be used as our plotting character. While we have not yet discussed linear regression, we can add the regression line to the plot using the abline argument. Here we will add the linear model that was fit to predict height using age. And again, we may change the color of this line using the col argument. We can change the line type using the lty argument. Let's use line type number 2. As well, we can change the line width using the lwd argument. Here we will use a line width of 6 to have a very thick line plotted. Now, we may wish to identify who is male and who is female on the same plot by using different plotting characters and or different colors. Let's discuss how that can be done. We would like to produce a scatter plot, first of age only for those whose gender is male, and plot this against the heights, again only for those whose gender is male. We've also noted that we may want to use different colors or plotting characters. Let's go ahead and use the color blue, as well as the plotting character of the letter M. You'll notice that the X and Y labels aren't very nice here, so let's go ahead and change those. We can relabel the X-axis using the xlab argument, and we can relabel the Y-axis using the ylab argument. We can also add a title using the main argument. Now, we should go ahead and add females to this plot. We can add more points or observations to an existing plot using the points command. This will allow us to add more points to this plot without overwriting this plot. Here we would like to add the age, only those whose gender is female, plotted against heights, again only for those whose gender is female. And as before, we would like to use a different color and plotting character. We will go ahead and use the color pink, and we'll use a plotting character of the letter F. In some instances, a plot like this may be what is desired. In other instances, we may prefer to have males and females appearing on separate plots. Let's talk about how we can do that. First, we're going to have to split the plotting screen so that we can have multiple plots appearing on one screen. You'll notice that R only produces one plot at a time. To add more plots to an existing screen, we can use the mfrow or mfcol argument. Here we will set this to have one row and two columns. This will result in two side-by-side plots, or two plots that are stored in one row, two separate columns. Now, we can go ahead and produce the plot first for males. I will also go ahead and set X and Y limits so that the two plots are directly comparable. Here, we can produce the plot for males. I'm going to go ahead and remove the change in color and change in plotting characters. And we will give it a title of height versus age for males. You'll notice that I had forgot to change the X and Y limits. So let's go back and redo that. First, we'll split the plotting screen into one row and two columns again. Then we'll go ahead and set X and Y limits. I will set the X axis to run from 0 up to 20, and the Y axis to run from 45 up to 85. Now we can go ahead and produce the plot for females. To do so, I'll just make a few changes to this existing plot command. Here we'd like to plot the age, only those who are female, versus the height, only those who are female. We will change the title to read that it is for females. And again, we'll keep the X and Y limits the same so that these two plots are directly comparable. The last thing that we can discuss is relabeling the axes. First, I'm going to go ahead and reset the plotting screen back to having only one plot appearing. Now, we can go ahead and first take a look at the simple plot of height versus age. Now, with a plot like this, we may want only certain values to appear on the x or the y-axis. For example, rather than having 5, 10, and 15 appear on the x-axis, we may only want the numbers 7, 14, and 21 to be there. Or we may want to include a tick and include the mean age on the x-axis. We're going to discuss how that can be done. Before we go ahead and do that, take note of how the axes appear before making these changes. We can see the x-axis has 5, 10, and 15 appearing on it, while the y-axis has 50, 60, 70, and 80 appearing on it. To produce a plot that does not have x and y-axes labeled, we can set the axes argument equal to false in the plot command. You'll see that this results in the same plot, except the x and y-axis are not labeled now. We can then go ahead and relabel these axes using the axis command. First, we'll go ahead and relabel the x-axis. To do so, we can set side equal to 1, which is letting R know we would like to label the x-axis or the bottom of the plot. Within the axis command, we must specify at which point we would like things to appear and use labels to tell R what we would like to appear. What we will do is we will have things appear at the position 7, at the position 12.3, which happens to be the mean age, and at the age of 15. Now the labels is where we tell R what we would like to appear there. At the position 7, we'll have SEV appear. At the position 12.3, we'll have the label mean appearing. And at the position of 15, we'll have the number 15 appearing. Now it's worth noting, you probably will not want to label your x-axis like this. We're doing this simply for the sake of showing how certain things can be put in using these commands. Now, let's go ahead and label the y-axis. Again, we can do this using the axis command. Setting side equal to 2 is letting R know we would like to label the y-axis or the left side of the plot. At the position where 55, 65, and 75 are, we would like labels of 55, 65, and 75 to appear. One thing we can do to complete this plot is add a box around this plot. To do so, we can use the box command. Entering this will throw a box around the plot or make it look a bit neater and tidier. One final note worth mentioning about this axis command is that we may also throw values on top of the plot or on the right side of the plot. For example, if we set the side equal to 4, this will put labels on the right side of this plot. At the position where y values are 50, 60, and 70, we may like to have labels of 50, 60, and 70. One thing worth noting is that you will probably not want to produce a plot that has the heights labeled both on the left side and the right side of the plot. What we're doing here is simply for the sake of demonstration and letting you know how you can put labels on the right side of the plot rather than the left side if that's what you choose. There are many more things that can be changed with these plots. For example, one may change the size of the margins. One may change text alignment. To learn more about all the different plotting parameters that can be changed, explore the help menu for the command PAR. Thanks for watching this video, and make sure to check out my other instructional videos.